So, do I have everything in place and is this 100%? No. So what happened between the previous episode and this episode is I came to the realization that I'm probably never going to be able to do this in a timely fashion, so I stopped playing the game. I actually went and played other games for a while. But, like, there's a lot of side quests that I can do in this, but I'm not gonna have enough time to do them. Like, I want to finish this game here and now. And even though that sounds pretty bad, where it's like, nah, I just want to get this done, I still think that this is a pretty fun game. I think that this might actually be my game of the year. At this point, it currently is topping the list, but. Like all of the other stuff, I don't have time for that. I'm probably going to go back through it and like do all the side quests like at another time. Maybe, but like as of right now, I don't really have a I don't really have a good answer to. I don't really have a good answer to what we should do besides, yeah, let's just finish the game right now. So, I've been holding off on seeing the end of this game for a while. I know what happens in it because it got spoiled to me when I looked through the list of names of things to capture in the things to capture with a camera. But that's okay. Now, I'm gonna throw a lot of shade, okay? I've been sitting down, playing some of it, watching most of it. Final Fantasy 16. And people that know me know that I actually really like 16's story. I know a lot of people that don't. But I'm not gonna get into the fight of like, oh, it's not an RPG or it is an RPG. I'm not getting into that particular fight, but what I will say is that the one thing that I did severely miss when it came to when it came to that game was I was missing the party members, like most of all. Like it wasn't even like it was even like, oh man, I wish I could play as another set of characters. No, it's not even that. It's I was missing the party dynamic. Ow. One second. Yeah, gloom reduction. I probably shouldn't bring in this many gloom items. I actually probably should, There we go. Fuse. Yeah, sadly I'm gonna have to depart with the gloom weapons. Oh my gosh, the Biggeron sword. Yeah, it's mostly because I don't want to accidentally use them. Oh my gosh. I don't want to accidentally use them. And like start sucking my health out. Speaking of which, I should probably get my health back. Just enough. What was the gloom restoration items? It's the glowing effect. There we go. Looks like it's just that that flower that does it, which is not fun. I would rather have the space for more food. I just. Okay. Four more? Yeah. Let's do, Mighty bananas. Mighty carp. Old tunnel. And yeah, let's throw in some rock salt. There we go. Okay, where are the defensive items? There's one. There's two. There's three. Get the rock salt in there. And meat, why not? There we go. Okay. This was one of the parts I was worried about. Because when I first ran through this, I encountered this guy, and I was stuck here for a bit trying to figure out how to get around him. Oh my gosh. I was trying to use a bow I don't have equipped anymore. There we go. Come on. Let's see. I just have to eat two more things. Eat bomb? No. No. Don't eat bomb. Healthy herb. There we go. Let's see. Dang it. Eat meat. Microphone died for a second. Sorry. Dang it. Oh my gosh. That was a lot of items. Okay, first off, eat. Paint. So we use three. Dang it. Okay, let's see. Star Fragment Rod. I forgot I had this. Soldier's Spear. Might as well just put like the best stuff on things just to kind of just kind of like help it. Just my attack part? Yeah. Look at that. Look at that majestic blade. It's so good. Soldier's Spear. Yeah. Okay. Ooh, very mysterious and highly suspicious. Yeah, when I originally came through this area, I'm like, oh, it's not gonna be so bad. Stop it. There we go. It's not the best thing in the world. I like how using a fuse, you can figure out which blocks are gonna fall. Ow. Power of a sage cannot reach you. Uh-oh. Okay. Oh my gosh. Okay, three items. They need zonite stuff on them. Okay, there we go. Wording. Okay. I think I might know a way to make my headset not freak out. And that is probably playing something very low volume, so it's not distracting to me. So it's not distracting to me, but also doesn't get picked up on anything. Okay. Oh, thanks, dude. Very useful. Okay. Oh, okay. I could have just gone up this way. Cool. Oops. Yeah, as you can tell, I already cleared this area out, like, first time I went through here. And hey, look at where we are. Forgotten Foundation. Ow. fact that this often works is really fine to me. Oh. Huh. Uh-oh. I forgot how these things work. Oh, fire. Yeah, and I showed the, yeah, lightning as well. And then I showed this, which now this makes a lot more sense. Again, like, I knew that something probably significant happened. When I uncover this, went, oh. So what I thought happened, okay, was that because I had already seen the one of eat the crystal, yeah, you eat the crystal, you become a dragon. That I saw this. And I saw this, I didn't connect that right there is the Master Sword in its head. I thought that the dragon was Raru defending us from the spirit realm. Like, that's what I had initially thought. But apparently I wasn't thinking hard enough. The imprisoning chamber. Okay. Place this here. If I have to head back for something, I'll head back for something there. And then Zelda's torch down here, which is pretty neat. That they remembered to actually put that down here. way. Yeah, there we go. That feels a little bit better. I don't think that works. Okay. Okay, we got past the first part. Oh. 1 second. Okay, there we go. Okay, moblins. Okay. Let's see. Not that button. Got it. I guess after that would be like multiple Kinox or something. Oh.
That gloom. It means but one thing. The Demon King is there, huh?
Oh. That was cute. Make that part like really, really hard. Yeah, make that part really, really hard. Unless you're a. Unless you've actually like done all the sages. Makes a lot of sense.
Insufferable light. All these weak, peace-loving cowards running rampant. Regardless, I will reshape this world as it was meant to be. I will crush any opposition. I will rule. That is what a king must do.
The Menace Unleashed is a great, it's a great subtitle.
Do not look away. You witness a king's revival. And the birth of his new world.
Gotta unmute myself. Up.
Perfect.
Uh-oh.
I've barely gotten started.
Ah, dang it. Dang it!
Is that all?
Why do I keep doing that? Stop! Man, I'm... Stop it. Stop it!
Take this! Fall! Is that all?
Ow. Oh my gosh. Stop it. Almost got it. Yeah. There we go. There we go. Man, I'm so rusty.
What a feeling. I had almost forgotten the thrill of battle. That feeling as blood surges in my veins. And I am not even near the limits of my power.
Demon King Ganondorf. There we go. Oh, wait, he was already Demon King. He's just now more demon. Or sage form? See what's going on. There we go. Oh my gosh, why is the bar so weird? Like, I just noticed how far to the right it is. Okay. Okay. Knocked him out of the face. Dang it. Almost got it. Oh my gosh! Keep crouching. Oh my gosh. Dick. Now remember, it's not because I would like to say I'm not usually this bad, but I am. It is a lot of because I'm rusty. But it's also just because I'm incredibly bad. Oh gosh. Oh my gosh! Stop it! Got it. Yeah. No, this phase is fine. Like, the problem is, it's just I'm incredibly bad. What? I equipped the shield. What do you mean? Like, I probably unequipped it and just didn't realize. Yeah. How was I supposed to know? Nah. That's a dumb question. It's like, how was I supposed to know I'm supposed to hit the balls back? This is a Zelda game? Supposed to hit the balls back. Also, my total maximum health has been going down this whole time, which is very annoying. Thank you. Yeah, now that I know exactly what to do, this phase now totally makes sense to me. See, this is the problem. It's not because I'm rusty, it's because I'm bad. Yeah, all I had to do was know that I could hit those back. That's suddenly an easy boss. That is. I should have known. I should have known that magic spells can be hit back at him. It's like 80% of the way that you take out Ganondorf in those games. Shoved his entire fist in there. Okay. Okay. The demon dragon. Oh, there I am. I kind of want to see a version of this where you did this without sages, without getting the Master Sword, and you pull the Master Sword out right now. I kind of want to see what that looks like. This would be where we would pull out the Master Sword. Or just cut to this. There we go. And nope. I tried to take a picture of the demon dragon. Did not work. Okay, self-portrait. Hey, I got it. I don't think I'm supposed to do it this way. Oh, okay. Got it. Yep. Okay. Hello. Whenever the snoot just, like, is thrown into my face, it's just really funny looking. Okay. Yeah, in a way, this phase is as easy as Demon Ganon was in Breath of the Wild. In essence, you know. In theory, this one's just as easy. Again, I went into this mostly blind to preserve the nearly blind nature of the beginning part of the playthrough. Uh-oh. Oh, there's one last one on his forehead, which makes sense. Yeah, there we go.
Thank you.
Okay, I didn't expect the, I kind of, unironically, I expected it for him to just kind of poof out of existence. I didn't expect a massive laser. Oh. Hello. Just finished Zelda because I wanted to put it on my Game of the Year list. And it felt awkward to have it not actually beaten, but still on the list. Apparently I fell asleep at this part of the stream, so I'm gonna just cut out the like 20 or so minutes that where I was just like suddenly passed out. Sorry about that. Yeah, super my bad. Yeah, it's a good thing I'm Yeah, I'm okay. Oh. There we go. Oh my gosh. I didn't know it was a hold. Yeah, I'm gonna look through footage to see how long that took me to realize that I was not doing anything. Man.
You, after all. He's gone. The Demon King. I'm not in a dream, right? You did it. Oh, Link, you really did it. I had been sleeping all this time. But when I felt something, like a warm, loving embrace, I woke up. Thank you. Link, I met such wonderful people. I saw Hyrule as it was. I have so much to tell you. So much happened. Oh, Link, I'm home.
Okay, there we go. Yeah. That Ganon fight was kind of hectic. But that's still a fun conclusion, especially if you've actually done everything to get here. But again, I would like to see what this looks like if you've done absolutely nothing. I guess, I guess my final thought on this game is that while I have a lot of problems with the way that they, while I have a lot of problems with some of the, the formatting of, like, certain scenes, I am gonna say that I did enjoy this story. The real question is this game better than Breath of the Wild? and I've heard people say that this game is not better than Breath of the Wild, which is interesting, but I'm guessing that... I don't know. Like... Like, as I was saying, like, I still think that, like, if they do another game in this series, aka, like, another game in this format, what I would want to kind of happen is for the map to now just be more, like, almost feel like modern day. If you've ever seen, like, the concept art of, like, modern-day Link on a motorcycle, like, I kind of would want the third game in the series to be like that, and the whole area to have sort of, like, this, modernized, like, interconnected small-town aesthetic. Almost have it feel like a, what's the correct term? Almost feel like Earthbound a little bit, you know? Where it's like, where it's small towns with, like, stuff in the middle. Where you just fight enemies. I don't know, I feel like you could do it that way. But I think my biggest, I think overall, my biggest problem with this game really extends to, to pacing format, how it feels like the game wants you to, beeline the main story and then do the side stories with ignoring every other side story until all the until the main story is done, and that just feels weird. So yeah, I definitely concede on some ground that that a lot of the pacing is that there isn't like a whole like problem with what they did. It just feels like it lacks they didn't think of several things, but I think the order in which I did things was pretty great, and then, like, one cutscene kind of ruins it. Because it didn't want me to do that one out of order on that one. But either way... But yeah. Yeah. So now that the game's over, and I could basically, Yeah, so now that I've actually like seen the like last little bit, I can actually definitely say that this does go on my game of the year list. Like, I probably would even say that, like, it probably takes the number one spot. The only thing that probably would have superseded it is if I actually did, like, put a lot more time into a few other games on my list. Okay. Okay, gonna just start looping images, I guess. I guess not.
I can't believe such an impressive landmass can float in the sky. Just when I thought I'd started to figure the Zonai out.
Everyone, I am glad I was able to bring you all here. I wanted to share this view of Hyrule with all of you.
Whoa! I've never been this far up before, Goro!
Wow, what a sight it is! And Zelda, you were roaming the skies all along?
Yes, although I don't really remember. I never thought I would actually stand here again.
This is only a theory, but Raru's power of light and Sonya's time power. For Zelda to transform back, they both must have channeled their abilities through you, Link.
I see.
Now it seems it is my time.
Minoru!
Do not worry. You have overcome the burden my era left to you. You have proven yourself, and you no longer need me. I know I can move on, join Raru and the others, and the world will be safe.
Oh.
Raru and Sonya will be happy to hear of this.
But Minoru...
And I'll let them know just how much you care.
Sorry if you saw a dip in frames there. I accidentally opened up.
King Raru, Queen Sonya, Minoru, the ancient sages. They wished not only to save Hyrule from the Demon King, but for it to see eternal peace. I will dedicate myself to that goal. Now, and for all time. My friends, with all of your strength, stand with me.
Yeah, sorry if you saw that dip in frames there. Actually opened up a Premiere as I was as that cutscene was going on. Well, I'm gonna have to edit both, Okay. The Demon King's profile has been added. Wow. 60 side adventures. Like, yeah, definitely not even halfway with like all the side quests and stuff. All. Yeah. Well, okay. I'm going. I'm going to skedaddle. I need to get ready for work in like 2 hours or something. But this was really nice. I got to finish two games in one stream, and feels nice to cross off one of them off my list so I can definitely say that this is like contender for game of the year for me. I posted my game of the year list like earlier, but like I'm gonna be like a little bit more exact when it comes to like certain placements. But as of right now, the only thing that would basically supplant Zelda right now is if somehow I played all of if I actually had like a deep dive into like every possible thing that you could do in Baldur's Gate. Like, I do kind of want to like sit down and go through like Baldur's Gate at some point, but like on a technical level, like that game is just impressive. So I have to at least like credit it to something, but it's more than likely not going to be my game of the year if I didn't even like fully play it, you know? Well, either way, I'm going to step in. Okay, so I've had a few, I don't want to say a few days, but like I've had a bit to kind of sit on mostly how I feel about this game overall. And I think the biggest problem that I, by the way, sorry about it being so quiet during that final bit. I forgot that the audio was down from Little Inferno that I played earlier this year. Like, and then like this was the immediate thing that I played after that. So the audio should be a little bit better now. But one of the things that I distinctly feel, okay, that I distinctly feel like marks this game as like being in the upper echelon of Zelda titles, to me, I firmly believe is the combat. I feel like overall, like this has been this and Breath of the Wild together. Has been some of my favorite Zelda combat in any game. The only one that gets close is the sword techniques from Twilight Princess, which is why I put Twilight Princess so high up. By the way, at some point I'm gonna restart this save file. Probably the next thing I do in Zelda is gonna be showing off 100% Korok seeds in Breath of the Wild, showing off that I've actually, like, fully done everything in that game. Oh, hey, everybody. What do you still have equipped? Okay, you still have a mace ball equipped. I think the most important thing about this game overall is that it's fun. And one of the important aspects about, like, Tears of the Kingdom is that it's pretty dark, you know? It's pretty dark with, like, its themes and, like, what everything goes on and the sub-stories, but the game is so fun to play and so fun to just, like, kind of sit around for both of these. But I can't stop playing this. Like, when I first picked up this game, I just wanted to do everything. And I definitely have to restart the save file. So probably the next episode in this playlist after it comes out is going to be me after replaying this whole game. The kind of explain where we're going with this. We now have a percentage meter, and it says that I have found 60%, which is a lot higher than the 32% from Breath of the Wild. But again, in Breath of the Wild, I'm also, like, not doing any of the DLC stuff, like, too much. I'm mostly just doing the base story. I actually don't care too much for the challenge, but, like, the DLC challenges stuff. And the thing that you get from that is you get the bike, which is pretty great. But what do I plan on doing after this? Okay, so everything in the adventure log I need to complete before when I get back. That's going to be complete 23 out of 23. A lot of the side adventures that I have done, I'm going to need to redo again. I'm going to actually go back through the footage at some point, and I'm going to actually write down every single, like, side adventure that I showed being completed. Okay? And I'm going to... Actually, I'm probably going to just redo all of them. Shrine quests. Specifically, any of the crystal ones, I'm probably going to just skip. I might actually just do all of the shrine quests. And then we'll just leave all the shrines. Side quests, definitely going to have to redo all of them. No matter which one they are, okay? Memories, it's clear that, like, that's completed. The imprisoning wall. But I think the most important thing is I need to get that, the missing things in the compendium. You know, I was like, I need to actually go back through, I need to figure out all the, like, stuff that I missed. Let's see. Very quickly. Any of the shrines that I have not completed on this, I'm gonna keep completed. Okay, I'm gonna keep all of these completed and all of these not completed, but I'm still gonna find every single shrine, you know? And I have on good authority that I have found all the shrines. But the interesting thing is that I look into this and it says, no, you've only completed 16 out of 31, which is really interesting to me because it means that there's a lot more shrine quests to do in the game, like by half. So definitely going to need to see what's up with that. More than likely, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to just, like, beeline the main story. I'm going to do all of these stuff in the order that they say to do it in, and then not deviate, period. Then when I get back, I'm going to have all the shrines, I'm going to have all of the side adventures to do, and I'm going to go back through, I'm going to write down which shrines I've completed on screen, and only do those. Even if it's like, and any of the shrines that are blessing shrines, except for I think one. No, I showed that weird blessing shrine on camera. And again, all of this side quest stuff, Like, I need to do again. Like, even the ones I've already done, I need to do it again. So, next time, I'm going to show all this. I'm going to do all of it. I hope to see y'all again very soon. Goodbye.